Hey dudes, this is the 8TB Cloud Store Mini from Blackmagic Design, which I've been using for over a month now. It's a high-performance network storage device with some global syncing functions. So there's a lot to love about the Cloud Store Mini, but there are some issues that Blackmagic Design could easily fix. So let's get into it. Inside the box, you'll find a welcome card, a Resolve download instruction guide, some plastic feet, and the Cloud Store. And that's it. There's no included power cable, Ethernet cable, USB-C, or HDMI cables. And you'll need these cables to get the Cloud Store Mini up and running. The build quality, it's solid. Design-wise, it's a simple metal box with ample silent cooling and connectivity. Inside is where you'll find the 8TB of storage comprised of four 2TB NVMe M.2 drives. Now, these drives come pre-configured in RAID 0 and pre-formatted in the SMB file protocol, so any computer system can access the data. The initial setup of the Cloud Store is very simple. Just add power, connect to your computer, and it will appear as a connected network drive. There's no learning curve, no formatting, no passwords, nothing. From here, you could start editing immediately in Premiere, Final Cut, or Resolve, but to gain full control over the Cloud Store, you will need to install the companion app software. Just jump online, download and install the correct version for your operating system, then connect the Cloud Store via a USB-C cable, launch and configure. Once complete, you can change all the settings, connect a Dropbox or Google account, and format the drive. After running a barrage of stress tests, here's what I found. When transferring a 1TB single 12K RAW camera original file via a Mac Mini to the Cloud Store over 10 gigabit Ethernet, it took 34 minutes and averaged 4.5 gigabytes per second, which is 2 minutes slower than my Thunderbolt DAS. That's impressive considering the bottleneck is the card and card reader. Removing the bottleneck and copying the file from the Cloud Store to my DAS took 18 minutes at an average of 7.5 gigabytes per second. Copying from the DAS back to the Cloud Store was 3 minutes faster and averaged 9.3 gigabytes per second, and at times completely saturated the 10 gigabit connection. So compared to my other drives, the Cloud Store, it's not the fastest, yet it does have fantastic sustained read and write speeds that are stable. It's also lightweight and portable enough to use on your DIT card. I use Hedge to verify camera media. The same 1TB file transferred in 53 minutes at a sustained 300 megabytes per second. That's not bad considering I was also running the proxy generator while editing 12K RAW on an 8K timeline in Resolve. I added a second computer to watch rushes and a second ingest, and that slowed nothing down. Both machines remained responsive with zero latency issues. Now, I'm not a networking guru, but whatever Blackmagic Design has done under the hood in here, it's rather impressive. Realistically, what they have made is a super fast network shareable DAS. I have no doubt that the Cloud Store could easily serve 3 users' large raw media files with ease, but connecting 50 users as Blackmagic Design states will depend on how optimized the media is that they are accessing and how full the Cloud Store's drives are. When the Cloud Store reached between 50 to 70% of its used capacity, it didn't slow down. And you can verify this in real time via a connected screen. This faux GUI also allows you to see each connected user, which connection type they're using, and how much data they are pushing or pulling over the network. But the really cool thing is this hexagon graph. Each hexagon represents a specific sized block of data, meaning that you can see the location or where each piece of media is being written to the Cloud Store. When you play the timeline and view the graph, you can actually see the data blocks following the playhead. If you scrub the timeline, you can see the highlighted active data dot moving accordingly, meaning it's easy to identify where your media is being stored on the Cloud Store. Obviously, I've set this up to illustrate my point, but imagine if Blackmagic Design gave us the ability to identify, track, and isolate bad clips, data, or disk sectors. Imagine being able to tell the Cloud Store not to use that part of the disk anymore. The future looks very bright for the Cloud Store, but as of now, there are some issues. While the GUI is fascinating to watch and it's helpful to understand the network traffic, there's no way of interacting with the GUI or any of the information displayed. Currently, all you can do is change settings via the app, and the app doesn't correlate to the GUI. Being able to connect a mouse and have some form of administrative control would be nice, as currently you can only see but not check who the connected users are, or if they're authorized to even be on your network. You also can't remove them or block unwanted users, which is just basic admin network tools. Another thing is, on a Mac, the Cloud Store appears as a connected drive, but it doesn't appear in disk utility, meaning that users can't choose a system-specific disk file format. I guess this is a trade-off for ease of connectability that the SMB protocol provides. But what if you don't need or want to connect Windows, Linux, and Mac machines together? I know I don't. If I could use APFS over the SMB protocol, then I would. That would be better for my system's integrity and enable data encryption for security. As currently, when online, the Cloud Store leaves your data security in the hands of your ISP, Google Drive, or Dropbox, and only you can decide if you're okay with that. Next, connecting a collaborative account may be easy, but I wouldn't consider 8 terabytes affordable. Dropbox quoted me $30 per month per user, and let me tell you, on a job that actually requires this, that's not cheap. I've had a lot of experience farming out heavy VFX jobs. My experience is uploading terabytes of raw data takes months to these services, which affects your deadlines, creates unwanted time constraints on remote artists who need the raw files, not proxies, to complete final renders. Today, it's still a faster option to courier a drive than uploading the raw media to a cloud sharing service. At $2,995, you've already paid a premium to create a network with 8 terabytes of internet shareable storage. It would be a much better product if it allowed direct remote access, client to client, like QNAP and Synology. Then you could avoid these expensive monthly third-party fees and also keep your client's project data private. Blackmagic Design could provide peer-to-peer secure direct connections via private session keys. This is something they already do with other products that connect and share content online. This could be a better way of providing on-device security while data sharing. But with all this in mind, the biggest head scratcher of the Cloud Store Mini is the 8 terabytes of disk space and its configuration. Look, let's be honest here. We currently have 4 terabyte camera cards. Blackmagic Design's own flagship camera shoots 12K. A 1 terabyte CFast card records about 30 minutes of footage in that resolution, meaning only 8 camera cards fit on the Cloud Store Mini. That's roughly 4 hours of footage without creating dailies, proxies, or cache media. It's not a lot. A simple fix would be to install larger drives, but this will void your warranty. Maybe in the future, Blackmagic will offer a diskless unit for us to populate or an upgrade pathway, but we'll have to wait and see. Then there's the RAID 0 config. If anything happens to infect the integrity of the RAID, your data is gone. It is not recoverable. You have to be careful deleting files or formatting the device. Granted, there are inbuilt fail-safe prompts to stop you from making bad decisions, but any connected user can still drag media into the trash and empty their bin, which will permanently delete the media from the Cloud Store. So, why did I get the Cloud Store Mini? Well, it's cheaper than its bigger siblings, and I'm not a networking guru. I looked into the other solutions from QNAP and Synology, but both brands have expensive startup costs, and both have steep learning curves. And what I wanted is ease of use, a simple connect and go solution to solve my in-house networking problems. And the Cloud Store Mini has delivered exactly that. It's allowed me to move all of my proxy and cache media away from my larger storage device. And while I still see the 8 terabyte as a drawback now, I can always update it after my warranty expires. What I'm looking forward to is how this product software could evolve the Cloud Store in the future. I would love to see Blackmagic Design incorporate cluster rendering into Resolve via the Cloud Store or Cloud Store Mini. That would be amazing. And with that, guys, I will see you in the next one.